We're about to battle another trainer in the Dual Square in Pyrite Town. Again, we don't have any... I don't have any Pokeballs, so we're just going to have to take down the Shadow Pokemon and come back for them later. See, this trainer has a Shadow Pokemon. Which one of these is a Shadow Pokemon? Well, there you have it. The Quagsire is the Shadow Pokemon. Again, I don't have a Pokeball, so I can't catch it. May as well come back for it later. So for right now, we're gonna have to just take it down. Best attack to take down Quagsire is a Grass type. So it's greatly effective since the Grass is a Water type and a Ground type. Ooh, that didn't do that much. Psychic attack don't work against a psychic type Pokemon. Like confusion. That Surf attack didn't do much against Croconaw because it's a water type. And Surf is a water type move. Again, that Reflect is gonna increase your defense against physical attack. Shadow Ross doesn't have a type assigned to it, so it just do the damage that it can get Buster. Okay, we're gonna have to take down Quagsire. Not much choice since I don't have any Pokeballs left. May as well come back for that Quagsire later. Let's snag it with this trainer. Let's see what else beyond here. Increases special defense. Grass types or special attacks, I believe. That helping hand attack will boost your partner's next move, like Shadow Rush. Works pretty well. Not a bad combination. And a 2-on-2 battle. And we're going to take down Quagsire. Just don't have any Pokeballs at this point. Come back and snag this one. Battle the last trainer in the Dual Square. This guy has a Shadow Pokemon, I think. Again, we won't be able to catch it. Because I'm out of Pokeballs. I'm going to get some more. One of these is a Shadow Pokemon. Ah, it's a Slugma. Slugma's a fire type, so a water type, or ground type, or a rock type will do well against it. The attacks, that is. Since we don't have those kinds of attacks, we're just gonna have to do what we can here. Bacchanal will work well with it, but as a the water type move would be thanks to his shadow Pokemon status right now. Yeah, Zero is a water type, as we use an electric attack or a grass type move. But since we don't have any of that, we just gonna have to do what we can here. Well, that worked very quickly. It's a critical hit. It came at a good time. That came at a good time also. Guess luck was on my side. Take down Spablu, I say use a rock type or ice type or electric type. An ice type will do extremely well. Whoopins is in hyper mode. Anytime a shadow Pokemon is in hyper mode and you get it to attack, it might not listen to it, so it's best to use the call feature. If you do take your chances, then it's shadow Pokemon move, Shadow Rush would be stronger during hyper mode. Though hyper mode does give you an advantage, but in some cases the Pokemon might not listen to you. I hung in there by a bit. That should be the last of the dual square trainers. See if this shop have any potions. Doesn't carry any Pokeballs. Still, you gotta go get them in the outskirts stand. There's Super Potion, Hyper Potions in there. Revive. Let's get as many as we can. Probably get some Revive afterwards. Oh, we forget something, while we? Okay, let's get the revive. Well, she offered you a deal. If a deal that good, I'd take it. Anyway, let's head to the Colosseum and see what's going on there. Yeah, this Pyrite town does have a secret. And it's not that good. Oh, she recognized someone. They may have won a Pokemon for getting into the Colosseum's challenge. Oh, looks like we're out of luck. Again. Guess we're gonna have to track down that trainer who won a Pokemon from there. Obviously, something is going on. He probably doesn't know that he had a Pokemon. a shadow Pokemon in his possession. But the only way to find out is to battle this guy. I say to take down that Ferret, you're gonna need a fighting type. Again, I don't have any more Pokeballs. I'm just gonna have to take it down and come back for it later. I think to get this guy a Shadow Pokemon, and if you missed it, you're gonna have to come back much later in the game to get it. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to miss it because I don't have the Pokeball to snag it with. That was a quick takedown. On routes. Routes would have been taken down quickly if a bite attack was used. It's in hyper mode again. All I gotta do is choose call. And that worked. It's in stage 3 now. According to the tank meter. Oh, that seed out hung in there a bit. I said, take down see that why it's still hanging in there. Oh, it's in hyper mode again. Choose call. Otherwise, if you do try to attack the broken arm, it might not listen to it. It does put you at a disadvantage when your shadow Pokemon is in hyper mode. Oh, almost it hung in there a bit. By the way, Cedar has a grass type. I say use a fire type or an ice type to take it down. Or a flying type. A flying type will work the best. Let's try to get Caulking out here because his HP is very low. Psychic attack will work a lot better with the, I guess, fighting type matchup. I say use Shadow Rush. It's much stronger than the other boot that Brockenau has now. Oh. SBI went down. But it worked very hard. Oh, that didn't do too much. See if a bite attack would take it all the way down. Thank you. Oh, that went critical. Got lucky there. Unfortunately, we didn't get the Shadow Pokemon. We're just gonna have to come back for it later in the game. But if you already have it, congratulations. To take down this guy's Shadow Pokemon, I say don't use the Fighting type, because you might end up taking it down quickly. Allow you to miss out on that chance. I say use a lesser attack, which helps to win his HP down just a little bit, but not by much. Oh, it's them again. That boss on the screen, you saw him and me. Night City. I wonder if that person has something to do with the Shadow Pokemon. This town does have a secret. Maybe Pyrite Town is their base of operation. What cave are they talking about? The sidekick is right. This town does have a secret.